I'm Mark Laszlo from the REDkit dev team. In this episode of the tutorial series, we'll talk about localization. For anyone unfamiliar with the term, it is a translation of the texts and voices to different languages and cultures. This enables a wider audience to enjoy your new content. And Thomas the Tank Engine modes are way more fun in your own language. The scope of this tutorial is the localization of strings. We will talk about localizing scenes, editing strings, and the available tools to handle the strings with ease. But what is a string? A string is a text displayed in the game, like a dialogue line, a tooltip, or a name. A string can have multiple translated variants, like English, French, German, and etc. The game will always select the variant of a string based on your selected language. Strings will sometimes have a short identifier called a key. Strings with keys have more generic usages like names, keywords, pop-up messages, and etc. Strings without keys are more specific to a system usually found in scenes used as dialogue lines. You can easily use strings in the scripts with the help of functions like getLogStringById or getLogStringsByKey, but it is always more convenient to use the key of the string to identify it. The editor has a feature called ID spaces. This feature helps you avoid string ID collisions between mods or team members working on the same mod. The ID space is the number your string IDs will be incrementally created from. You can set your mod's ID space in the settings. This number should be unique to your mod, because if another mod uses the same IDs, your mod will override that mod's strings or the other way around. Setting your ID space to a value that no other mod uses will help you in the long run. It is advisable to set different ID spaces to different developers in your project, so no ID collisions will happen between developers. That way, synchronizing your databases will be easy using the localized string editor's import and export feature. You can read more about ID spaces in the documentation. As we have seen in the last tutorial, we can create or edit scenes, add dialogue lines, and play them back. So let's play this one. We can see that they are talking in English. So let's change that. If I change the language to German and I play it back again, they are still talking English, but you can see the strange EN prefix. That EN prefix comes from the language system because it didn't find any German translation for these strings. So let's change that. If I go to the screenplay, I can still see here the text and they still have the EN prefix. So let's say, Geralt will say, Guten Tag. And the Elfman will reply, ja. And I will apply the changes and save the scene. And if I go back to the preview and I will play, you can see that Geralt says Guten Tag and the Elfman replies with ja. So this is the way you can translate the dialogue lines easily inside scenes. Under tools, we can find the localized strings editor. This is the main hub for localization. In this window, we only see strings that have keys. You can filter the strings by category, or you can search in the strings, but watch out, the search is a little bit slow. By checking each checkbox, we can display all the strings that are modified in this mod, or it's a new string in this mod. But we can see this list is currently empty. So let's add the new string. I will say test key. The value is this is a test. And if I press save, this is saved to the database. So let's check out the export tool to see it in a CSV file. If you click File and Export, we can see that it exported 10 strings with translations. If I open up the exported CSV file, we can see that our custom text appeared. It's here. Test key, this is a test. There's only English translation for this now. So let's add the German one. You can edit this file in Excel or your tool of choice, but if we go three to the left, we can say this is a test, but in German. And I save this CSV file. If we go back to the UI, I can change the language to German, and we can see that there's still a fallback text here. But if I say file, import, and we import back the text file from the export folder. There was one imported string for one languages, and you can see that The German version of this string has been updated. If we change back to English, we see the English version. Thanks for watching this episode of the tutorial. Check out the other episodes if you want to learn more about REDkit. If you have any more questions about REDkit or modding, feel free to hit the forums or the official Witcher Discord. See you later, and remember, localization comes with no strings attached.